Hey guys, welcome to EDITAP. So today we are going to cover a global competitiveness report. This report is very much important as it was released in the month of October recently. And we'll be covering this report through 5 MCQs. So if you know the answer, you have to mention the correct answer below. And if you don't know the answer, you'll get to know because we'll be moving on to the solutions also. So as you know, this video is going to be helpful for RBI Grade B, NABARD Grade A, as well as the SEBI examination. So here you can see the various courses which are being offered by us, and also the importance of this particular series, 5 MCQs a day, in the examination of SEBI, RBI and NABARD. And telling you quickly about our previous results, you can see that in RBI Grade B 2017, 27 of our students got selected. Then NABARD Grade A 2018, 26 selections were there out of 46 seats. And similarly, RBI Grade B 2018, 250 plus students have been selected in Phase 2. So here again, we are expecting a great result because interview are yet to be done. So moving on to the lecture. Okay, so let us just start with the topic of the day, Global Competitiveness Report. Are you all set ready for the questions? Okay. So the very first question is, Global Competitiveness Report for the year 2018 has been recently released. Which of the following releases this report annually? So first of all, you get to know that it has been recently released. That means Global Competitiveness Report for the year 2018 we are going to talk about. And secondly, the report is released annually. So this is also an important thing. You can just note down that GCR's report is released annually. So the question is asking which organization actually releases it. So let's see, is it a World Bank, International Monetary Fund, World Economic Forum, World Trade Organization or UNCTAD, that is United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. Even if you don't know the answer, you can just try it. What do you think is the answer to this question? Give yourself 10 seconds. Okay, so our answer to the question is WEF, that is World Economic Forum. So this particular forum releases this Global Competitiveness Report every year, and it has released the report for the year 2018-19. Now it is an annual publication, and it was first published in the year 1979. Now about this 2018 edition, which is very much important because to the report they have added, there is this Global Competitiveness Index which is actually involved, included in this GCR, but this year they have included GCI as 4.0. Now you should know that GCI 4.0 does not mean that it is actually related to the fourth competitiveness index. Rather, this is related to the fourth industrial revolution, and that is why it is called as the 4.0 competitiveness index. Now basically about this report, if we talk about it, is designed to help policy makers, business leaders and other stakeholders. So it is a kind of partnership between the government and the business organization. So public private partnership is there so as to boost the economy, and so that policy makers can actually take help from the this particular report. So yes, that would be it. Now let us see about the body, World Economic Forum itself. So it is, it was founded in 1971. It is basically a not-for-profit organization, and it was established by Professor Klaus Schwab. Now Professor Schwab is himself the executive chairman of this particular body, and he is the one who actually established this organization. Now another important thing is that you have to know that WEF does not operate under United Nations. It is rather a not-for-profit organization. Coming to its headquarters, it is based in Geneva, Switzerland. So earlier it was established as only a not-for-profit organization, but now it has a formal status since 2015. That means the formal status means it is recognized as the forum which is of the International Institution for Public-Private Cooperation importance. So it has a very much importance in this particular public-private cooperation. Since 2015, it has been recognized formally. So all important things we have covered here. Now let us move on to your question number two then. Okay. So, which of the following is not one of the main pillars of the productivity which are used in the assessment of Global Index, Global Competitiveness Index 4.0? So, this is, since this report has this Global Competitiveness Index, so it has various pillars. Now, you have to identify what do you think is actually not a pillar under this Competitiveness Index. So, is it ICT adoption, that is information and communication technology, infrastructure, innovation capability, health, or do you think that all of the above are the pillars of this particular report or this index rather? Okay, you can just try it even if you don't know the answer. And our answer is option 5. That means all of the above are actually the pillars of this particular index. We will see how this is here. So GCI 4.0, that is the fourth industrial revolution global competitiveness index, has recognized 12 main drivers of productivity, which it calls as the 12 main pillars of productivity. Now productivity is being given focus here because it is directly related to economic growth, and this report has actually suggested that if there is this economic growth, then people will be coming out, and finally human development will be there. So very high value is given to the factors of the fourth industrial revolution in this particular report. Now what are these factors? You can just see here 12 pillars which are actually categorized broadly under the four headings, that is enabling environment. So enabling environment is basically providing the environment for productivity, which includes institutions, infrastructure, ICT adoption, then macroeconomic stability. Yes, so these are the four important factors under the enabling environment. Then moving on to the human capital, so health and skills are related to human capital regarding the productivity. Similarly, for market, there are a product market, labor market, financial system, and the market size. So these are the factors which are actually decided by the World Economic Forum only. And the last two are related to your innovation ecosystem. Obviously, if we are talking about the industrial revolution, which the fourth revolution, which is related to the digital revolution. So here comes business dynamism and innovation capability. So these are the 12 major dynamic factors which are involved in this particular index. Now also this report has stated that the fourth revolution is going to offer the various stages for the economies to leapfrog and develop further, but also since the digital revolution is there, so there is less certainty. So you can just go through this slide particularly. All important things are mentioned here. Okay, so moving on to your next question, question number three. Okay, now this is the typical examination question. Which of the following countries has topped the Global Competitiveness Index 2018? So whenever we are covering any report or index, we have to know the rankings. Apart from knowing the ranking of our country, we have to know the top countries of that particular index or the ranking. So you have to identify the correct answer. If you know it, mark it below. Is it Switzerland, China, Japan, USA, or Singapore? See, even if you don't know the answer, you can just give a guess that out of these economies given here, what do you think, which economy is actually going to top this competition index? So our most probable answer becomes here USA. So that is the correct answer only, option number 4. So USA has topped this index for the year 2018. The competitiveness score is also given along with the rankings, and the 100th score is actually called as the frontier mark. That means that the country, when it scores frontier mark of 100, it would be the ideal state of the country, where the perfect score of every component which we have already discussed, the 12 components, every perfect score is there with them, and therefore they'll be getting a 100 score. And USA has 85.6. that means USA is still far away from obtaining the 100 score. So last year it was topped by Switzerland, this year USA. And there are 12 main drivers of productivity we have already seen, and on the basis of these different indicators, the cumulative score is calculated, and based on that score, the ranking is given. Okay, so question number 4 is, what is India's rank in the Global Competitiveness Index for the year 2018? Again, a typical examination question. Apart from knowing the top countries, we also have to know about the rank of our country. So, what do you think it is? Is it 77, 58, 140, 40 or 10? So 140 countries have been actually assessed in this index, and our score for this year is 58. A rank, I would say. The rank is 58 because score has a different definition. So 58 is our this year's score. In the last year, there were 137 nations which were assessed, and India's score was 40. So this year we have a 58th position. And if you see the 77, are you able to relate to any other index which was recently released and we have covered it, to this ranking of India as 77th position? Okay, if you are able to recall it, do mention it below. What do you think the 77th position in which index India's position is? So this Global Competitiveness Report has given this index in which India ranks 58 out of the 140 nations. And this 58 rank is important because it is considered as the largest gain of any G20 nation. Now, apart from this, India and China are considered as the top performers in the upper and lower middle income brackets. So upper middle income bracket, the China has topped it, and India being in the lower middle income bracket. Now, apart from knowing India's rank and the top nation's rank, you also have to know about the BRICS economies. So Brazil, Russia, India, China, South Africa, where China has topped in this list, being at the 28th place. Russian Federation is at the 43rd position, India at 58th. Apart from this, you also have to know, which is a very important finding of this report, that India is actually the main driving force of the South Asia's economy. So that means India has a very vital role in the South Asian economy. And last year, India's rank was 40th, as we have already discussed. So shall we move on to the final question? Okay, so recently World Economic Forum has announced its center for fourth industrial revolution in which of the following countries? Let me just tell you that this particular question is not directly derived from the report, but this is very much important because we are discussing about the Global Competitiveness Index, which has its focus on the fourth industrial revolution. So there was recently this center announced for the fourth industrial revolution, and this is very much important. You need to know this. So if you know it, please mention it below. Is it India, Japan, China, USA or Singapore? And our correct answer is, it is India. So World Economic Forum is going to establish its center for the fourth IR in India. Now, there was this announcement recently in October 2018 itself, and The center will be based in Maharashtra. So although we don't know the place or the exact location, but World Economic Forum is going to support India. And apart from this, you also have to know that this is only the fourth center. That means there are three centers already working, and joining in the chain of the three centers would be the fourth center of India. So these three centers are located in US, Japan and China. They are already functioning right now. And from Indian side, Niti Aayog will be coordinating the partnership on behalf of the government and would work for the center along with various ministries. So Niti Aayog has a very important role, and let me just tell you that if we are talking about Niti Aayog, I have mentioned it earlier also, and you must know that Niti Aayog is actually one of the nodal agencies for the sustainable development goals. So this particular competitiveness report is actually also related to SDG 8. So SDG 8, we have discussed all the SDGs in various previous videos. So just find it out what is SDG 8, and whatever relevant information you get, please do mention below in the comment section. So here are the correct answers. Just tally your score. Do let us know how do you like the video. What is your score in this particular lecture? So yes, that's it guys. You can visit our website if you want to know about various courses which are being offered by us for various examinations. So that is www.edutab.co.in. You can also drop us a mail at hello@edutab.co.in, or you can even call us or WhatsApp us at the number given, 8146-207-241. So yes, that would be it guys from today's lecture. Do let us know about your feedback, and if you like the video, which I really hope you would, please do not forget to like, subscribe and share. And this is the link of our Telegram channel. You can go there and download the PDF of this lecture and all different lectures in this particular series. So yes, that would be it. I wish you all a very happy learning from the team EduTap. Thank you for being here.